We've talked about other people's flaws and mistakes in their training and what they should have done differently and how they could improve. What would you say you yourself, or what would you have done differently to have a higher level than you do now, if you could turn back the clock?
Well, I remember Master Sam Tam said to me more than once years back. He said, your problem has been, and now and then also be, not right now, that you have too many interests. And by at that point, I was running different business, and I actually even had when I'm turning 58 now, and I was turning 50 there, and I had a couple of months reunion with the weight training, which I didn't do for some years, because I wanted to see how kind of that kind of shape can become coming quite fast, which by the way turned out quite good. I was also the same year visiting quite a few different teachers, not to learn from them, but to meet them. And of course, if I could walk away with something, that would be nice. And in a way, I was a bit annoyed with Sam Tam saying that I have too many interests, and but because he didn't say it as a positive thing. Then, as usual, when I went back, I started thinking, oh, how come you become annoyed by that? I mean, if you are grounded in yourself with what you do, you shouldn't get annoyed. There's no point in getting annoyed. And then I start thinking, maybe it's because I myself also think some now and then that I had too many interests. Then a couple of days after I had these thoughts, I had a client coming in, and this client, who was a new client, emphasized in the sort of entrance speak we had that one of the reasons he had picked me was that I had quite a bit of experience in different things. So I start thinking, that's the way I am. I mean, it is one of my strong points that if people talk to me about anatomy, I am capable in that. The same with Chinese medicine. If people tell me that they went to Alexander Technique for years, or they go to psychotherapy or whatever, I've been doing it for long extended periods, going deep, and then I skipped it again, and I've been doing that for quite a few things. I'm a curious guy, what can I say? So it's also my strong point. But if I look at it solely on Tai Chi, if I had focused only on that, I would be more skillful than I am today, I believe. Mm. I think so. So if you want to, by the end of the day, evaluate me and only in the sense of how great did that guy become in Tai Chi, you would say that, well, he wasted some time on doing something else. But it's not how I feel about it.
Mm-hmm. Do you think that if you had started with Tam's system, that you would have been better than you are now?
No.
Why not?
See, that's also a thing there, but I'm not sure that I would get that popular with Master Sam Tam saying this. I'm definitely sure that I wouldn't be too popular with all the students Master Huang Xianxian in Europe and around the world. But for me, and the way I teach today, to start out with some of the basic things in the system of Master Huang Xianxian and build on that before you go into the system of Master Sam Tam, is a faster way to develop. Because what I have seen with Master Sam Tam is quite a few big guys, because they're into power. So they come to this little Chinese skillful man who has a lot of power. So they focus on that. So when they start standing with their tension, And then they stand longer and they build tension upon tension, according to me. If you start out with relaxation first, really learning how is the vertical circle functioning, relating to gravity, all these kinds of things, then it's an easier step to start with the other things. You will get challenged by not being too heavy, but starting to become lighter again. It took me a year in daily practice, but still I would say it's a shortcut. And only stick to the way most people do within the system of Master Wang Xianxian. But on the other hand, also, if you will develop like this, but then it will flatten out the curve. So I think it's beneficial, both of us. I even when I teach students, I also take things in from the Zen style. I don't teach them the form. I might take in a couple of movements, because having a little focus on the spiral and things, early on today you asked me about, you know, what about the theory of spiraling here and there and so on. Theory is good, but practice is better. And if you bring in a couple of movements where you focus on spiraling movement, and then you understand that concept and bring it into, for instance, the Yang style and so on, then it's all of a sudden a completely different form. Not from a guy who watches it from outside, because it's still the same form, it looks the same, but inside it's different. That's also why it makes it internal. Internal stuff, you can't watch them from outside. I mean, think about it. Go one step back and think about internal. If you can see everything that takes place from outside in, how can it be internal? It's externally that you work with something that affects something internally. But here we do it the other way around. We work with something internally that will have a huge difference externally.